Hello and welcome to another episode of the Daily Roundup. I am Aditi.
And I am Prashant. And here are the major stories of the day.
Mayawati exposes BJP's record in Delhi rally. Who are the godmen backing Adityanath? A Newsclick exclusive. Activists protesting clean chit to CJI detained. Chelsea Manning is free for now. US imposes fresh tariffs on China. BSP leader Mayawati today addressed a rally in support of her party's candidate in Northeast Delhi. Referring to several promises made by the BJP, she claimed that it had massively failed in delivery. She said no development was carried out for minorities, Dalits and backward castes in the last 5 years. She also heavily criticized the concept and implementation of demonetization and GST and added that poverty had only increased due to these steps taken by the Prime Minister. Finally, she struck back at Modi's comment on the Mahagathbhandan. He had claimed that unlike the BSP and SP, caste was not an issue for him to play politics over. Mayawati said he could only make such comments because he didn't understand the struggles a lower caste person goes through in this country. Continuing with the Mahagathbhandan and the BJP, we move to Uttar Pradesh, where these two political forces are amidst a fiery battle. From Ayodhya, one of the epicenters of Hindutva politics, our reporter Antariksh has sent exclusive footage of godmen who seem to be close associates of Yogi Adityanath. Later, we also see Yogi Adityanath attending a religious ceremony along these men in a temple. But all this happens amid terribly underdeveloped schools, roads and hospitals. Let's take a look.
पृथ्वी के अपना भी तो कोई देवता होना पड़ेगा कि नहीं वो देवता वो जो दे देवता का मतलब दे और देवता कौन है ब्राह्मण ये तो पृथ्वी के देवता है ये मनुष्य में आने आते गिनती ही नहीं कर रहे
राम का काम हमारे माननीय मोदी जी माननीय जोगी जी कर रहे हैं
राम जन्मभूमि के नाम पर ही तो गए हैं ये पहले कितने जाते थे दो सांसद जाते थे ना हैं दो सांसद जाते थे तो राम जन्मभूमि के नाम पर तो ये केंद्र में राज कर रहे हैं स्टेट में सरकार बनी है सब जगह सरकारें बनी है राम जन्मभूमि के नाम पर था
नहीं वो कहते विकास के नाम पे
कौन
मोदी जी कहते विकास के नाम पे
कि कभी की नहीं कोई भी सरकार आती है तो विकास करती है
तो इस बार चुनाव सिर्फ राम मंदिर के नाम पे होगा
जी
विकास के नाम पे वगैरह
बिल्कुल विकास के नाम पर क्या होगा विकास क्या है हमें तो राम जन्मभूमि चाहिए
माननीय योगी जी का आगमन हो रहा है और आज योगी जी के आगमन से
सुरेश दास जी महाराज बुद्धि से जो कार्य नहीं करना चाहते हैं ऐसे हमारे धर्मदास जी महाराज और पूज्य संत परमहंस रामचंद्र दास जी महाराज के प्रति आस्था का भाव रखने वाले सभी श्रद्धालुजन 72 वर्ष पहले देश आजाद हुआ था देश के प्रधानमंत्री जी के अनुसार कि 2022 में जब देश की आजादी के 75 वर्ष पूरे होंगे तब हम कैसा भारत चाहते हैं एक ऐसा भारत जिसमें गंदगी न हो जिसमें अव्यवस्था न हो जिसमें भ्रष्टाचार न हो जिसमें कोई अराजकता न हो जहां आतंकवाद न हो जहां कोई नक्सलवाद न हो जहां कोई भेदभाव न हो जहां कोई अभाव न हो और इस प्रकार की व्यवस्था ही राम राज्य कहलाती है
Since Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi received a clean chit in the sexual harassment allegations leveled against him, there have been continuous massive protests against this decision. Today, two protesters gathered at Mandi House but were whisked away by the police and detained. CPI leader Annie Raja and lawyer Anjali Bhardwaj said that they had gone to the office of a local in charge of the area yesterday and informed him of the protest. They said that they had received an affirmative response from him. But that did not stop the police today from stopping the protests and taking those involved to the police station yet again. Our team were at the scene. Here's what happened.
जो पार्लियामेंट स्ट्रीट थाने पे जो बैठा है डीसीपी साहब उनको मिलके शाम को मिलके हमने लेटर लिखित में दिया और उनको हमने जगा भी बोला ये नेशनल स्कूल ऑफ ड्रामा एनएसडी के सामने हम सब लोग इकट्ठा होगी उधर से हम मार्च करेगी करके उनको पत्र में लिख के दे दिया है उनके साथ आधा घंटा से भी ज्यादा हमारी बातचीत हो गया उन्होंने भी इसमें मना नहीं किया था आज यदि उन लोगों ने पुलिस ने दिल्ली पुलिस ने किसी के आदेश के अनुसार यदि इधर 144 लागू कर रहे तो शर्म करना है दिल्ली पुलिस को ये दिल्ली के अलग अलग जगहों से लगभग 200 महिला और पुरुष और बाकी साथी जो भी है इसमें शामिल होगी ये भी हमने बोला और टाइम भी बोला 12 बजे और उन्होंने मना नहीं किया था और अभी बोल रही है 144 इधर लागू है शर्म करना है और आप हमें डरती है तो आपको डरना है इस देश की कानून को तोड़ मरोड़ करने वाला सुप्रीम कोर्ट को ऊपर आपको 144 लगाना है कार्रवाई करना है एक पीड़िता के साथ अन्याय कर रही है वो पीड़िता को कानून जो देश में एक कानून है उस कानून के आधार पर उनका केस को देखना था वो नहीं किया वो सब कानून को नजरअंदाज करके साइड पे रख के चीफ जस्टिस अपना एक कमेटी का गठन कर रही है
In the international segment, we first look at the release of whistleblower Chelsea Manning. Manning was released after 62 days in prison on May 9th. However, there is still the possibility that she might be sent to jail again. Manning was sent to jail for contempt of jury after she refused to testify against WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange. On May 16th, Manning has been summoned again by another grand jury, probably on the same matter. If she refuses to testify against Assange once again, it is possible that she may be sent to jail for another 62 days. Chelsea Manning was arrested in 2010 and convicted to 17 years in jail in 2013. She was pardoned in 2017 by the Barack Obama-led administration. Manning and Julian Assange together exposed US war crimes in Iraq and atrocities in many other places. Activists and intellectuals across the world have once again mobilized in support of Manning and Assange. Our second story is about the US-China trade war that is intensified after the US once again imposed $200 billion worth of tariffs on Chinese goods. This is a follow-up to the trade war that broke out last year when the US once again imposed $200 billion worth of tariffs. These tariffs come just a day ahead of the negotiations that were about to happen between US and Chinese authorities. These negotiations are nonetheless likely to continue. However, this is expected to affect these negotiations. The US and China have a very complicated trade relationship, with the US importing nearly $539 billion worth of goods from China, while exporting only about $120 billion. The US believes that China is using unfair practices and lowering its prices to ensure that its goods are sold in the Chinese market. However, the US solution for this has been to impose tariffs, which has affected China's economy very strongly, in a very bad way, and the global economy as well, including that of a lot of developing countries which depend on China. It is unclear as of now what China's response is going to be to this move, but it seems likely that in the following days, there will be more such war between China and the US. That's all we have in the international section for today.
So that is it for today. To learn more about these and many other important stories, do visit our website www.newsclick.in. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook.
Before we leave, let's take a look at the media scene today. Most of the media in the country, including many TV channels, seem to be in the thrall of one party and one person. In Newsclick, we decided to see if there's a need for a different kind of media. So here's our latest show.
के अंदर कोई भी सरकार की गलती बात करेंगे जिसके बारे में